Welcome friends. In the previous video we discussed about personal interview, and in this video we will discuss about the telephone interview and mail interview and the observation techniques. Earlier I told that in the previous class session I told that the personal interview the advantage and disadvantages, but in a telephone interview, yes, there are advantages and disadvantages. With the set of questionnaire, we can contact the person where even in a remote we can contact through phone, okay, or through fax survey or voice mail or survey, something like that, okay. So in this telephonic interview method we can contact more persons through phone, but we cannot ask an elaborate responses from the respondent, because when we are calling, they won't be in a mood to answer, or they are busy, okay. So we can't insist them to answer, and they won't patient enough to answer for more than 20 minutes or 30 minutes. But in personal interview, yes, they can take the questionnaire to their home or whenever they are free, by the time they can answer. So in the telephone interview, what I'm saying is, it is one of the disadvantage in collecting the information, right information, and we have to wait for the respondent time, okay. In the office hours they won't attend, in the house or in their house they won't, they will concentrate only on their personal issue, and only if they relax in the home they can, or in the office if they are free only by that time. So these are all the some disadvantages in that telephone interview. So to either the researcher directly contact the person, or the researcher or the administrator appoint somebody else to get the right information. If it is a standard question, you can appoint anybody, or if the researcher presence is there, only the researcher directly contact, okay. Some market research survey or some product innovation survey, in that only the researcher attention is required. By the time we cannot allocate the some other person to collect the thing. Then mail interview, putting mail, okay, and it is quite common nowadays, and whenever the respondent have time, by that time they will answer, okay. So the survey methods through personal interview or telephone or mail observation, we can collect the primary data. And again, electronic interview also, through email interview technique or web-based interview technique also, we can collect the data. Then coming apart from the observation, sorry, survey method, we have another technique is called as observation techniques. In the survey method, we are giving the questionnaire and answering. But in the observation, we are watching and recording his behavior respondent without interacting. Okay, direct versus indirect observation, structured versus unstructured, distinguished versus undistinguished, human versus mechanical. So here, he is doing some work, respondent. Okay, what he is doing, directly or observing or indirectly without knowing him, somewhere else we are standing, or the respondent don't know about whether he is observed or not. Okay, maybe his behavior, or when he is going for the purchasing in a shop, how does he select the component, where and all he is going, how many brands he is searching. While searching the brand, what he check, whether the weight or price or whatever in the label. So thereby we can understand what sort of personality he is, he or she is. Okay. When he is coming for the purchase, we are coming alone or with the wife or with the kids. When they are coming with the family, who is taking the decision that is going to influence the purchase decision. Something like that we can observe, okay, directly or indirectly. And structured and unstructured, maybe through structured question, okay, some system is there, only these things to be observed, or without any structure we can observe. Distinguished, unaware, and undistinguished, he is aware of that. Human or mechanical, here human, a person will record the data. Mechanical, an instrument, maybe a camera will record it, or an automatic, some other instrument may record it. Okay. Observation method, personal information, mechanical observation, observation audit. So So here the observation, or that is a personal observation, the person directly involved. Mechanical observation, some instrument, camera, some other machineries may record it. A market basket is another thing, observation audit. In the market, the consumer while coming and coming to billing, what they purchased, okay, directly they are verifying in the basket from that. Then content analysis. Inferences about the intention, attitudes, values of individuals by identifying specific characteristics in the textual message. Okay, then another thing also, physical trace analysis, past behavior. Okay, for this observation method or for survey method, we need a questionnaire. Again, how to design the questionnaire? There are some around 10 steps are there. So while you are constructing the questionnaire, the first one is specify the information needed, what you want. Okay. As a respondent awareness or respondent personal characteristics, or respondent will be a judge, what sort of information you need, that you have to very clear. Specify the type of interview method, whether it is interview method or survey method. Okay, we should be clear whether personal or personal interview or telephonic interview. Okay. Determine the content of the individual questions. What sort of questions will be there? Okay, if you want to understand the demographic characteristics, we have to include that question. Sometimes the demographic questions details are not required. So no need to collect the demographic details. Okay, maybe there is no connectivity between brand choice and income. Why are you unnecessarily collecting the income details? Okay. There is no connectivity between the class of people, rich or poor, and the brand image. No need to collect. Okay. So like that, something is not required, we no need to. What is required, only that. Okay. So determine the content of the individual questions. Design a questionnaire respondent friendly. Okay, we should not use some high-fine languages. The respondent should easily understand and able to answer. That is respondent friendly. Decide the question structure, mode of asking. So here, you are asking a particular brand of television or computer, okay, about the particular brand performance or particular model performance. When you are asking the question to the respondent, without asking are you aware of that or not, you cannot ask the question what is your view about the particular brand or model. So first question is, are you aware of that model or not? Are you aware of that brand or not? And if a person said yes, then only ask, how do you feel it? What is your rating or what is your ranking? If the person didn't know about the particular brand, then the remaining question is meaningless. So if he said yes, then only continue with the question 7 or 8. If you said no, okay, either skip or some other answer. Okay, what are the other models? You know that. Maybe brands of model A, he knows about the model B. Then you raise the question regarding the model B. Okay, so here the structure. First, are you aware of it or not? Yes, then go to the question 7. No, go to the question 8. Like that, the structure should be clear. Determine the question wording. Okay, it should be easily understandable. Arrange the question in a proper order. Why? Which is first, which is second? Without asking yes or no, you should not ask what about. Okay. And identify the form and layout. Reproduce the questionnaire. Okay. Here, the reproducing the questionnaire means, maybe as a researcher, I may frame the questionnaire. I may develop the questionnaire. After that, directly I can't go for the survey with that questionnaire. I have to check with my friends who are knowledge about in that, because we are not a good expert, we can't claim that something we may missed that may be corrected our colleagues or our co-researcher. Okay. One of the researcher in the field, he told that on the delivery, so 17 times I gone back, 17 times I verified that. Such a difficult question, and he is admitting that yes, 70 times I reviewed. And eliminate, that is why I'll reproduce the question. Whatever time you want, or how many times you want, you check. Maybe as a student, you may check with your faculty guide, or you may check with your organization guide, or some other expert. Okay, check it. Then eliminate the defects by pre-testing. Okay, though it is 16 times or 17 times or with some other expert, it is verified. Okay, you can conduct a pilot study or with so few respondent, that is validating with the respondent. Earlier we discussed. Okay, so we have to validate with the respondent or with the market or among the respondent. Then, and on that, no double barrel questions. Are you good and productive? This is the two things. Are you good? Okay, one question. Are you productive? Second question. The two good things or two bad things or two fact, two things to be, should not be in one question. That's called as a double barrel question. So there should not be any double barrel questions. So these are all the steps while we are forming the questionnaire and design process. So with that delivery and also with the previous delivery, I covered survey methods, interview observation techniques and the questionnaire design process. Okay. So in the next class, we will discuss about the sampling. Thank you.